back to Dr. Sucheta's interactive class. Today, again, we'll continue with the chromatographic technique as an analytical tool with a new technique, ion exchange chromatography technique. We all know that the invention of chromatography is done by a Russian botanist, Michael T. Svet, in 1906. He was doing a research on plant pigments. He utilized the chromatographic technique to separate various plant pigments like chlorophylls, anthophylls and carotenoids. First time, this technique was done by T. Svet utilizing calcium carbonate as stationary phase in this column, chlorophyll extract and ether as a mobile phase. He observed that these plant pigments were separated as color bands on column by utilizing this technique. So this technique has been termed as chroma, that is colors, graphy defines writing. So color lighting of plant pigments. Chromatography is most powerful tool for separating and measuring the components of complex mixture. This technique is utilized for qualitative as well as quantitative analysis by using two phases, one mobile phase and another stationary phase. Ion exchange chromatography is most popular method utilized for purification of proteins and other charged molecules. The solid stationary phase utilized in ion exchange chromatography is there are resins are utilized as a stationary phase. These resins are classified as cation exchange resin and anion exchange resin, where cation exchange resins are positively charged molecule which attracts negatively charged molecule for a complex mixture, and anion exchange resins are negatively charged molecules which attracts positively charged molecules in mixture to separate based on charge. The separation of molecules is carried out. So ion exchange resins are classified as cation exchange resin and anion exchange resin. Cation exchange resin, depending upon the capacity to exchange the ions from the given mixture, they are further classified as strong acid resins, weak acid resin, strong base resin and weak base resin. Strong acid resins usually contain groups like strong acid group, SO3H group, and in market they are available as Dovex 50 or Amberlite IRA 120 as marketed cation exchange resin, strong acid. And weak acid resins contain the groups like weak acid COOH group, where marketed resin available is Amberlite IRC 50. Strong base resin. Can you quote the example for strong base resin? Which might be NH3, the base known to you. So, NR3. Tertiary ammonium groups are act as a strong base resin, and marketed formulation is Dovex 1 and Amberlite IRA 400, whereas NH3, the weak base resin, is utilized. NCH3 is the weak base resin utilized as an anion exchange resin with marketed formulation Dovex 3. The structure of the resin, what actually resin is, it is a polystyrene group. Polystyrene group. You can see here the two benzene rings which are attached with alkyl group CH2CH. This resins are having cross linkage. This is your polystyrene group CH2. So this is a polymer. Poly and styrene. Styrene group. So this here it is shown SO3H group, that is anionic sulfonate group. So this resin we can call it as strong cation exchange resin. So these number of R groups, number of SO3 minus HR groups present on the polymer defines the capacity of resin to carry out exchange of ions during separation process. The process of exchange of ions, the exchange reaction takes place during separation of ions on this ion exchange chromatographic technique on the column, as these are the positively charged molecules, negatively charged molecules, you can see they are passing through the column. So positively charged ions, molecules are attracted towards the negatively charged molecules. This particular column contains anion exchange resin, as negatively charged molecules, so positively charged molecules get attracted on this anion exchange resin and negatively charged molecule get separated out. The reaction takes place during cation exchange resin and anion exchange resin on column, usually for the exchange of ions, that is exchange takes place between. So this is SO3 minus H plus. So SO3 minus attracts the positively charged molecule and exchange takes place between positive ions. H plus is exchange with calcium. So if your mixture is contained calcium, magnesium ions, it will get exchange on your cation exchange resin with H plus ion and reaction takes place as RZSO3 minus H plus plus Ca2 plus calcium 2 plus exchange with this particular RZSO3 and H plus are released. Here the anion exchange resin, the reaction takes place between this positive charge ion attract the negatively charged molecule from the mixture and exchange takes place between OH minus and Cl minus to obtain the separation. During the separation, the highly charged molecules are more tightly bound to the resin. Highly charged molecules are more down. Moderately charged molecules are equilibrated between resin and the buffer solution which you are using as a mobile phase. And less charged molecules are obtained or moving forward and eluted first from the column. So mobile phase utilized here should be charge less or buffer solution to maintain the charge on the solvent which you are utilizing. During the process of the separation, the column, once it is filled with the resin, you are putting your substance on the resin. This is the step. This is your resin. You are putting your mixture on the resin. These are the binding sites shown on the resin. Once they attract a specific molecule from your resin, other molecules are removed. Suppose this is a cation exchange resin. These are the negatively charged. These are the SO3 minus from this attract this positively charged calcium over here and it binds over here. So these are the negatively charged molecule which are remained aside and eluted from the column. So positively charged molecules are binded on the column. Once you will get separation of this process, you can regenerate the same column by giving acid wash. You can regenerate the column. You just utilize dilute acid. So again, reverse reaction, calcium and H plus ion will exchange the reverse reaction. The opposite reaction of this, you are washing this column with acid. So you're while washing this column, SO3 minus will attract the H plus ion from the washing solution and it will place again the column and you will regenerate the column and utilize again during the separation. The process of obtaining a separated compound is elution process. This ion exchange chromatography has very wide application in day-to-day life. You are getting pure mineral, demineralized water, pure water you are getting, AquaGuard you might have placed in your home and they might have telling you that after 6 months the change the resin or change the material inside, you need to replace the material inside the particular machine. So regeneration of column, you have to place the resin. Once the capacity of resin to carry out the exchange is fulfilled, there are no more ions, no more sites for exchange of ions, you will not going to get demineralized water from that particular instrument. So you have to carry out the process of regeneration and replacement of the resins in your purification units. Separation of metal ions utilizing anion exchange column. Amino acid separation you can carry out. Total content of cations in solution you can carry out. And concentration of trace elements. So these are the broad number of application. We'll see few of them application in details. Demineralization of water. That means impure water. So how you can define hard water or impure water? Which contains dissolved salts like calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate or salts, chlorides, bromides. So you are interested in removing calcium, that is positively charged ion, chloride, negatively charged ion, OH minus, negatively charged ion from your water to obtain only H plus OH minus ions. How it is possible? We'll see. Now, this is the column of cation exchange resin. So, it will carry out exchange of ions of H plus and Ca plus, calcium and H plus. Exchange of ions it will carry out from your impure water. So, you are pouring that raw water over cation exchange resin. So, it will exchange sites are available for calcium on the column. It will release H plus and negatively charged ion SO4 minus and Cl minus from it. This particular diluted solution has been again passed through anion exchange resin. What will happen over here? SO4 2 minus and chloride will exchange with OH minus sites on the column and it will release H plus and OH minus H2O from cation exchange resin. So you are getting H plus OH minus, that is demineralized and deionized pure water. If you have attached further the degasifier unit over here, you can remove the dissolved gases too. So you'll get a pure water by this process. Sometimes mixed bed resins are also utilized to carry out this process of demineralization or purification of water. Amino acid separation. If you write the amino acid structure of the amino acid, so carbon which is attached to four different groups, which are those? Yes, very good. H, COH, NH3 and R. So if I'll write the structure, I'll get positive charge on ammonia, on this particular COH group negative charge. So and a structure having positive as well as negative charge on it, what we can call that structure as Zwitter ion, Zwitter ionic form. So it actually behaves, amino acid having Zwitter ionic form behaves neutral pH. So that pH of particular amino acid is varying with respect to the R group, with respect to their dissociation. That pH is defined as isoelectric pH. So for every amino acid, the Zwitter ionic form and their isoelectric pH values are differing. If I add on this particular Zwitter ion group, if I add hydrogen, addition of hydrogen, or if it accepts the proton, what will happen at low pH value? It behaves in its cationic form and form acid, where it loses the proton or it donates the proton at high pH, where it shows the structure anionic form. So depending upon the isoelectric pH value, you have to change the buffer solution during the separation of these amino acids. Suppose you are having a column of mixed bed resin, cation exchange resin or mixed bed resin, then you have to pour the mixture of amino acid and apply the mobile phase with increasing pH value. So as you are increasing the pH, depending upon their isoelectric pH, it will lose from cation exchange as well as anion exchange resins as it becomes a neutral molecule at particular pH and it will elute out. So in this way you can separate out amino acids utilizing ion exchange chromatography. These are the few references I have quoted over here to get a detailed knowledge of further ion exchange chromatography for your studies. Hope you have understood the ion exchange chromatography, types of resins, their application and actual process taking place during the separation of ions. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe my channel, Dr. Sucheta's Interactive Class. Thank you.